also had the Dutch government telling the government of Sint Maarten in parliament to distance themselves from your foundation.
Yes. Well, the take we took on that is this. You have a two-man foundation that's been in existence officially for about, let's call it 7 months, 10 months, let's call it that. At the time, it would have been less than that. And you're telling a government to distance yourself from from this foundation in exchange for 60 million guilders. Let that speak for itself. That speaks for itself. That shows you our value.
Yeah. Were you surprised?
Not really, because again, dealing with them in court and seeing the back and forth and seeing the cognitive dissonance of the Dutch state and the fact that they're refusing to look at the evidence, and that's why they're always deeming us inadmissible, because when you deem us inadmissible, you don't have to deal with the issues. You just deal with the foundation and dismiss the foundation, and you kick that can down the road. So we were not surprised when they told the government to distance themselves. But for the record, the government and ProSwaliga have never met. We've met with parliament, but we've never met with any members of the government, any ministers. We haven't met with any, with the prime minister or anyone. We have had meetings with members of parliament, obviously. But there was no need for government to distance themselves from us, because we had never been in contact with any member of government up to today. I've heard that that's the case. That is not the intention. The intention is basically to try and get Holland's attention rather than to make them tremble.
Yeah.
Well, you know, ProSwaliga Foundation is not overly surprised. If you go back to the beginning when we were dealing with at the time it was called the Caribbean Reform Entity, there was huge pushback from all the parliaments, from Parliament of Curaçao, parliaments and governments of all the three islands, you could basically say, telling them the same things that the Council of State or Raad van State have just said today, or in the leaked document of today, that it imposes on our autonomy, it imposes on our rights to govern. If you want to come in and fix government, quote unquote, there are other ways to do it, less draconian, less vile ways of doing this rather than a 7-year takeover, and also using liquidity as a carrot on a stick, if you want, exchange for, fixing our government. Now, our governments do have problems. We do have liquidity issues, financial issues, but there's a more diplomatic way to deal with it, and I see that the Council of State agrees with that.